football.
Wow, that ball is not free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. Off the play fake. Ross. He's going to rifle one deep left side. Oh, no. The first throw of his career is intercepted. And the Lions are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive.
Well, they certainly took a shot to open this game. And I know it backfired with the interception, but no lack of bravado from that sideline at all. And look, they told us before the ball game, they wanted to be a little more dangerous on offense. They wanted to take a few more chances. That opening pass certainly set a tone. Maybe a turnover, but I don't think it'll stop if you're trying again the rest of this game.
And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. Another run for Gibbs here. Only gets 3 yards there on the heels of the 1 yard pickup. Sets up third and six. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Throwing on third down, Fields. Oh, his first throw of the season is intercepted. And the Cowboys will take over possession here up at the 44. So consecutive interceptions here early on in this one, and maybe setting the tone, Charles, for a game where the defense really takes center stage.
And don't you think that both offenses are really catching a bit from their coaching staff about avoiding these turnovers that we've seen early? I think both teams are trying to find an advantage. We know that. Can one of them break away and take control of this game?
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Let's go now. Second and 10. They'll give up the middle to Johnson. And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
And force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
Here now a third down and 8. Operating from the gun, Ross. That gain on third down, good for 28. There you go, Charles, the first completed pass of his young career.
And we expect it not to be his last. Very good to get the first one out of the way, though, as he begins his career.
To throw is Ross. Throwing on first down. Throw left side complete. That's Hunt. And they'll get this down to the 10. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
A nice completion there for the first down. And Charles, you think about the quarterbacks of recent vintage that have been thrust into action week one. It's no guarantee of future success, but we sure have seen some good ones.
We certainly have, partner. How about Joe Burrow with the Bengals in 2020? He was excellent. Kyler Murray with the Cardinals. The best part about his game, had his team run the brink of the playoffs. And Deshaun Watson has won division titles after having started from day one.
He'll get two out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal.
Now, that's the defense that they were looking for, being able to get extra bodies to the point of attack to deal with the big guy carrying the ball. You really don't want to be in a position where it's a one-on-one tackle with him.
The line of scrimmage, the seven now on second and goal. Johnson on the counter. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Cowboys take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown.
Sometimes you get a first and goal and you're back near the 7, 8, 9 yard line and you start thinking, maybe we'll run it here on first down to get half of what we need, so maybe we can have 2 or 3 shots at going for it from closer range. So this is a bonus right here. What a great run to work his way into the end zone.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Keyshawn Nixon now from his end zone. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. And a good return, able to get out across the 35 to the 36.
Here we go.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Back to throw, Fields. That's caught. It's Sam Laporta. Sam Laporta, 66 yards. And the Lions are able to strike quickly here as they are in for 6. Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, 2nd and 10 from the 25. Operating from the gun, Ross. That's into the hands of Gallup over the middle. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Another completion there, and you think about the draft back in the spring. He's selected in the first round, getting the start here, as we mentioned, in week 1. It's got to be quite a whirlwind for a young quarterback.
Absolutely, because going in the first round, people are going to clamor for you to be the starter right away, but many teams want you to get your feet wet first. You know, maybe just kind of hang out behind a veteran starter. In this case, though, he ascended right to the top role, and I know he's excited about the opportunity. And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
The throw over the middle, taken in. Touchdown, Cowboys! A great play there. 57 yards. And the Cowboys have taken the lead. Seeing some pretty good offense here in this first quarter.
It's been a wild start to this quarter, as you noted. And now with that lead that we're seeing, can they retaliate? I get the the sense this one's going to go back and forth all game long.
And that probably won't be the last long touchdown that we see in this one. Nixon now from his end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
Man, confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. Second and 7 from the 20. Now it's Fields. Being chased out left. And Fields going to have the first down before sliding to a halt to avoid the contact. We'll give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
This early in the game, it's all about making steady progress downfield, hoping to lead to early points. And you can do it with your actual play calls, or sometimes something a little more improvised, as we just saw there.
So first and 10 now from the 30. On first and 10, here's Gibbs. And pretty good pursuit there defensively. He's brought down, no gain on the play. Second down coming up.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Second down, and they go back to Gibbs. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
Got what he needed for the first down with a gain of 2. They'll go again with Gibbs. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43. From the 43, here's a second and 9. Fields. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
In most pass defenses, the guy playing safety has the ability to roam free and try and go to the football. But when you're in man, you've got to cover just like the guy playing out on the corner. Lock up on the receiver and go to the football. That's exactly what he did, batting that one away.
Here's Fields. And that is incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
And here now the punter, Fox, as he sends this one away. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3. Through one quarter, 14-7 our score. Now second and 7 from the 23.
operating from the gun. Ross. And he's got it. Got his man on the end round. Complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Over 100 yards receiving for him now in the opener. And it's a first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Ross now on first down. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. The middle, Johnson, and he'll lose yardage here back at the 47. Now they had stopped him for a loss on the run anyway, so they'll decline that.
It's almost a good psychological advantage, isn't it? You created a penalty and you still couldn't gain yards against us. No way we need to take that one.
Ready. Now Ross to throw on second down. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45.
They made a nice effort to stick it with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
Here is third down at 4.
19 tight.
Off play action. Ross. He'll fire this deep for Gallup. Oh, he had a man running free, but he overshot him, and it's incomplete.
A little bit of finger pointing and heavy discussion going on in the defensive backfield. It's man coverage, but they leave a guy wide open. They've got to be counting their lucky stars that this ball was overthrown.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback.
Here we go.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive.
Over on the sideline, hoping to hit that reset button between possessions. Last time out, they had to punt it away, this time hoping to finish this thing off in the end zone.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Good defensive call right there because they had someone shadowing him along his entire route. And he was right there ready to provide a hit that prevented from making another catch to his big start.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Gibbs straight ahead. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
That was a really nice run there to bring up third and short. After the incompletion on first down, it's awfully nice to have a running back that you can hand it to and put you back in a good situation.
The offense on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. Fields going to get this one out on the perimeter. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down. On 4th down, Jack Fox on to punt for Detroit. On the return is Lamb, able to power through. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a 1st and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
No points last time out. They were forced to punt, if you remember, but no time to dwell on that. They've still got the lead here and a chance to add to that here. 1st and 10 as this new drive starts.
The first down carry here for Johnson. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. He'll lose.
lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
No daylight for him to run through there, and he ran into the defensive tackle, and that guy blocks a whole lot of daylight as it is. He is truly a big man who just made a big play.
Here's Ross, looking to throw on second down. Over the middle, hauled in by Lamb. So the completion good for 6 yards, and it brings up third and five now.
A nice throw right there, and these fans getting their first look at their QB1 of the future. I'd imagine it's got to be a big plus for him to get his first start here in front of that home crowd.
I know there's a school of thought about getting your first start away from home so you don't have the extra pressure of that crowd behind you, but I say ride the wave, embrace it. Go ahead and play to that level, and I think it's going to benefit him in the long run.
Ross from the gun on third down. This one swung out to Vaughn. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. An excellent pickup of 20 yards.
Another completion there, and what a big moment in a young quarterback's life, that first NFL start. And Charles, obviously they want him to win games, but if they're looking at him under a microscope in this first month or so, what do you think they're hoping to see from him?
Well, for every question they'll have for him, they should have for themselves as a coaching staff, because it's not just how quickly can he learn the offense, is what they can teach him, right? How can he build a relationship with his receivers? And, of course,
got a man. It's caught inside the 10. Touchdown. Great effort there. Already his second touchdown here this opening weekend. And the Cowboys have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now 21-7. The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away.
Nixon now from his end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick three and out when they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28. Off play action, Fields. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Like somebody thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down.
Fields now to throw.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Yeah, he's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. So possession goes over here on the punt, and that will come the offense as they take over. At their own 22-yard line.
Come on.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They'll start on the ground here on first down. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
So if you've been playing defense in this one, there's a little bit of the good and some bad, because they did give up the touchdown run to him earlier, but shut him down otherwise.
Outside of that, you're exactly right. I would say they've contained him very well.
Here's Johnson again on second down.
And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. They wind up losing a couple there, so they go behind the original line of scrimmage. And now 3rd and 11 coming up.
Backed up here. Tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first.
On third down, Ross. Pass to the sideline and pulled in.
And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45.
This offense in midseason form here in the opener. It's first and 10. Looking to throw. Ross got his man there, complete to Gallup. Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6, and it'll be second down. Continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down.
He did have the touchdown run earlier, but not a heck of a lot more than that throughout this game.
No, not at all. In fact, I would say that this defense has done as good of a job on him as they have on any runner in recent memory.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. To throw is Ross. From the gun on third down. And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And with him down 2 scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Gibbs. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. From the gun, here's Fields. He gets this out wide to Gibbs. Will go down as a gain of 6, and that'll bring up second down. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive, not much sense. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit, but get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Again, Fields. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. First down, Fields. There's LaPorta, and he's got it. Touchdown, Lions. A great play there as the first half is winding down. And the Lions are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And they're back within a touchdown at 21-14. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with a 7-point lead, they'll likely look to take this to the locker room and not really press the issue. Gonna take a shot for Gallup. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted.
I believe this is what you would call growing pains here, partner, because this defense obviously took the challenge facing the rookie, and they wanted to help indoctrinate him to the NFL. So now the big question is, can he answer that challenge and rebound with plenty of time remaining in this game?
Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10. That throw taken in by Jameson Williams. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. That's it for the first half. 2 more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. Nixon now from his end zone. And all deep in his own territory. Coughs up the football. Well, one of the linebackers has got it. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy because you want to make sure that the catch is secured. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery. But he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. Here's Fields. He's airing it out for Williams. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be 3rd down.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball. But he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. To throw is Fields. And that is incomplete.
And so many times we look at the opening drive in the 3rd quarter as a tone setter. And many coaches do emphasize it. And that's a strong performance there defensively to force the incompletion and, more importantly, force a quick punting situation.
Lamb to return it. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And it will be 1st and 10 as they take over. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because
that's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Cowboys! A big play there. 61 yards. And the Cowboys are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that pushes the lead up to 11. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Nixon now from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. See if they can put this drive in the end zone, Charles, because it's been a little bit of a rough go at times. They've had to punt the football a ton in this ball game because of stalled out drives.
So are you saying that you're kind of tired of seeing the punter run out there and do his thing during this game? Is that what you're trying to say?
I'm okay with it. I have a feeling that this offense, they don't want to see the punter again.
And frankly, the punter doesn't want to run out there anymore himself. He would love to see his offense put together a drive and give his leg a rest.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for him. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
Stays on his feet, and he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 55 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 13 times.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
Going back to Gibbs on first down. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Consecutive positive runs for him on the last two snaps. He certainly appears to be trying to put the offense on his back and just move them down the field when his number is called. The way he's running it, I keep going back to him.
Here's Fields now on second down. Going underneath, Gibbs has it. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth. Here comes the Lions punter now. He's been terrific so far. And this will be covered up. Pretty good result. It'll be down at the 14-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one. I tell you what, that's a veteran play from a guy in his first season in the NFL. A lot of rookies are trying to force something there. He thought better of it, and that was the right decision.
Now a 10th carry for Johnson. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. This defense could use a few more plays like that right now.
It certainly could, but think about it from an offense's perspective right now. They've got a lead, but they don't want to throttle down too much and stall themselves. Still want to move at a nice pace.
Ross now to throw on third down. Flushed out right. Able to find a lot of empty space there. Picking up the first down in a 21-yard gain.
And we both know there's a lot that went into why they made him their first-round pick this year. Part of it was what they saw in college, his playmaking ability when things break down. As soon as he saw he wasn't getting a lane to throw, he pivoted and found an alternate way to the marker.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Second and 10, third quarter of the season opener. From the gun, a run for Johnson. And he'll get two, maybe three, up near the 37.
The way things have gone in this one, the running game's been something of an afterthought, and that's not been too bad for them, has it?
Yeah, the offensive returns have been good, but I guess we figured he and the ground game would be a bit more involved.
Now Ross on third down. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First and 10.
That was a round run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
Running from the gun, Johnson. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Early down stuffs have put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
From the 48-yard line, here's the second and eight. To throw. Ross. From the left side, it's complete. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 26. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Now a handoff, Johnson. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I thought he did a nice job there setting an edge and make sure nothing could get to the outside. But he decided that wasn't enough for him. Worked his way back inside and made the tackle on the ball carrier.
Here's Ross, off the play fake. This is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. A great effort there. With now 3 week one touchdowns. And the Cowboys are looking good here. The season openers are able to extend their lead. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead is up to 18 now. The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. Nixon now from his end zone. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30, right about the 29.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get 2 more possessions.
So from the 37, here's second and 2. Now Fields. That is incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Looking to throw. Fields. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Normally on third down and short yardage, you're thinking to throw to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field. And a nice dart picks up the first down and then some.
Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in, and he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. We are
are through three quarters here on NFL Kickoff Weekend. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Arlington, it's the Lions trailing but with possession of the football as we get set to bring you the fourth quarter. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Short throw to Smith. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And that's going to bring up second down.
It's now second and 6 at the Cowboys' 22-yard line.
Now a give to Gibbs, running left. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 74 yards rushing for him now on 17 carries.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Right back to him on first down. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Well, partner, I guess sometimes it's just a matter of philosophy. Some say run until they absolutely stop you, and others say, well, when you think they're about to stop you, fool them a little bit. I guess they should have tried to fool them on that play.
Looking to throw on second down. Fields throws out left. It's caught by Williams. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds, right around the 7. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it makes it third down and 2 yards to go. Back to throw. Fields. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. Mozzie Smith, he fought through to record the sack.
You can almost see all the defenders rubbing their hands together with glee because we all know they relish the chance to bring down a quarterback of his caliber. Anyone who brings him down has plenty to talk about. Not just a sack, but a big win built off the efforts of this defense.
Fourth down, Fields has to have this one. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Justin Fields with now 3 week one touchdowns. And the Lions have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. Extra point by Patterson, up and good. And that'll make this now an 11-point deficit. 2 scores down, 3 timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. 2 scores down, 3 timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And the Cowboys are able to recover. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
They stay on the ground on first with Johnson. And a 5-yard gain as he's down inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. Good gain there on first down. It keeps them in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front. Good blocking. Nice hole for him. Ends up picking up nice yardage. Stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively. Here's Johnson. He's been busy this afternoon. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation when they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it are not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously, but at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
Now he dumps this off over the middle. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal.
But when you're up by two scores in the fourth quarter and you're going to throw the football, expect to see a lot of man coverage, because usually what comes along with man coverage is pressure. So if you're a play caller and you want to keep throwing the football, that's fine. Just make sure your offensive line understands they're going to get additional guys running at the quarterback.
And only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now, backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake at the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover.
And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. And that one really pushes him back. A loss of 9. And now it's third and goal after the sack. Back to throw. Ross under pressure, and they got to him again. A very costly sack there on third and goal pushes him back big time. And now you figure the field goal team coming on fourth. And his kick is good.
So after 5 touchdowns offensively, hey, maybe it's time to get the kicker a little work, and he's able to connect there.
I love that empathetic side of you. You're worried about him getting some action, getting to be a part of the game. Well, he got in and got it done.
The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away.
Nixon now from his end zone.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. On first down, it's Fields. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
Now a 2nd and 10.
Now it's Fields. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
Well, they've had success getting the ball to him out of the backfield, but this time they had a man right on him. He was able to break that play up before he could get started.
Throwing on 3rd down, Fields. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
It's a gain of 35.
Throwing again is Fields. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
Another try, 2nd and 10 now.
Out of the gun, Fields. Trying to lay one up deep. And in for the Lions, touchdown. A great play there. 48 yards. And the Lions have made it a 1-score game again here in the fourth. They get one more as the extra point's up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. So just under 2 minutes to play, and this would figure to pretty much be your ball game right here. Oh, did the Lions get it? Yes.
Jets, they recover.
So they've accomplished half the mission, Charles. They get the onside kick. They do need a touchdown here, but they've got some time to do it.
In the excitement, there's no need to press. Plenty of time. They have the opportunity. Now they just need to execute and finalize things.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Here's Fields.
The last time out, they had to march almost the full length of the field for their touchdown. So here, much easier, Charles, with this better starting field position.
I love your sarcasm, but I love even more your observation because, look, what they did last time out, now with a shorter field, they should have a lot of confidence that they're going to put more points up on the board.
Here's first and 10. The give, right side for Gibbs. And he's able to motor his way down to the 16-yard line.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Here we go.
Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now. Another run for Gibbs here.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
They'll come up now on second down. All eyes on Fields. Over the middle to Smith.
It drives some people crazy to see those short throws underneath. They gotta find a way to gash the defense downfield.
Well, this one's had a season's worth of thrills already, and it's still week one. Here's third down now.
And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. Now the offense gonna use the first of their timeouts as he'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock.
Gibbs is in for a Lions touchdown.
And while it appears the heavy lifting was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down one. That extra point is not a gimme.
And now they're going to go for two and a possible win as this crowd rises to make things difficult.
Now Fields. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted.
And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. And he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will. His head play backfires in a big way. So still a chance with just over 20 seconds to go, but they need to get this one back, no doubt. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. The risk-reward of the onside kick. When you don't get it, the risk comes out to play. And here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them. And field position leads you to that type of play calling. And whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things, now that they've given up that type of field position, the advantage is switched to their opponent.
The CD, always a little extra excitement for week one, and one of our early window games here in week one on a Sunday comes to a close. Good to be back in the booth with you, my friend.
And it's good to be back in the booth with you as well. And we know that not everyone's going to start the season 1-0, right? Half the league is going to have a loss on their record. But everyone's going to have to build off of that opener. And how many coaches tell us every single year, you make your most progress between week one and week two. We'll see how both of these teams progress the rest of the season.
So for Dallas, it wasn't always pretty, but they do eke out the week one victory here by a field goal. And they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for Detroit,